Hello everybody and welcome to episode 54 of the Pentagon Challenge, and today we'll actually be skipping forward to the fourth game of the Asian Champions League group stages. It is of course against the Central Coast Mariners away this time, and the consequences of messing up again are far too high, as we suffered a really disappointing defeat against Saitama United. So it leaves the group looking like this. We have the Mariners dominant on the maximum 9 points, but then every other team has won once and lost twice. But by virtue of goal difference, Ulsan Hyundai are now the second best team in the group. So we've basically lost 3-0 to the Japanese club away from home, and that's put us in a really dangerous position because we had the perfect opportunity to go 3 points clear of Ulsan and we failed to take it. So that means we have to win probably two of the next three games to stand any chance, and to be honest it's probably going to have to be Ulsan at home and Saitama at home to stand any chance, whereas the Mariners look too good to be restricted. So we're going to try our best in this live come anyway, but we'll talk about how difficult it's proven to be for us to defend our title. So when we last met it was still the last game before the league season began, and Rick Scott was the creature of our undoing, and he looks in pretty good form. He's been very average in the A-League, but in the Champions League it's a totally different story. But then yet again on the opening day of the Chinese Super League we've lost, and that gave everyone else a bit of a head start, including Guangzhou. It's the first time they've beaten us in a long time, and it was a few minutes of madness that caused the defeat. Quinn Wan and Hang Pengfei each scored a goal, and that meant we were well and truly doomed at that point. It was just a dreadful performance and we didn't deserve much out of it. But then let's talk about this 3-0 in a little bit greater detail. In fairness, we deserved one goal. I do feel we were really, really good in the second half, but it was the first half we got pummeled, and by giving away two goals on the cheap, it meant that Saitama were going to run away with it, and unfortunately even got the third goal as we went for the attack, and that just meant the pressure was really, really on us, and at least we subsidised some of it by getting our first home game of the season converted into a win, and it was thanks to Peng Changming once in each half that made sure of that result. But against the team that we were beaten against last year, we managed to improve slightly with a 2-2 draw. It is, of course, Yangsu Santi. We went behind not once but twice, but we recovered the result, and I'm pretty satisfied. The players couldn't have done any much more than that, even though we hit more shots on target. So the Super League in the very early stages looks like this. The reigning champions falling behind the likes of Renhe and Ayurban. They have the maximum 9 points, whereas we're stuck on just the 4. I don't know why the form guide suggests we've lost 2 games, but that maybe just be a technical glitch or a cosmetic glitch. I don't really know, but either way, the two major clubs I'm expecting a title fight from, Guangzhou and Shangang, they are slightly ahead of us. But if we hang on in there, I'd say it'll be okay. The home win was crucial. It's the one and only time we played, but away from home, it's not so good. And I just want to see that improved for future, because we won 21 times in 30 games last year, and I have a sneaky suspicion with so many club commitments this year, I don't think we'll do it, but we'll give it our very best shot, and if we can defend the title, I'll be really, really proud. But a few question marks will probably be coming up with my future at the club. If I can't win the Champions League with them very soon, then I have to say goodbye and move to probably the A-League or the K-League, and that'll give me a better chance of becoming the champions of Asia. So anyway, it's now time to play the Mariners. They lost the most recent game to Adelaide United, I think. So I'll just show you the team very quickly, but the formation needs to be changed. I'm playing Dujia in goal, Fu Huan, Daniel Mullen, Gao Zunyi, Ma Yuben in defence, Yang Zifei, Kaiwi Kang, my defensive midfielders, Danny Moreno and Zhang Long on the wings, Ji Minghao in attacking midfield, and then Peng Changming, the lone striker. Let's just see what the Mariners have to do to respond. I'm just multitasking a little bit here. Let's just see what they have in store for me. The manager is very confident of a victory, and that'll secure the Mariners' place in the knockout rounds, whereas I need a favour from Saitama and Osa, and I need them to draw, or basically one of them to lose, so I can beat them next time. Let's just see what they've got. Pretty much the formation I want to play with. They've got Saric up top today, so and that could be handy. Slightly different lineup, so we'll try and beat them. So let's put Hui Kang here and Zeming Hao there. That makes sense to me. Everybody seems to be A-okay. So ball winning midfielder defend, that's cool. I have a pretty useful bench, but we'll see what I need to do with them later. So where is the guy who scored the hat-trick against me? I'm not too sure. Anyway, it seems like he's gone from the lineup. Jochevsky is the guy I want to watch out for. I might just look out for him actually off camera, see where on earth he's gone. So as it transpires, Rick Scott is on international duty, but I'm not going to ignore the threat Nick Saric poses by any stretch of the imagination. Even at the ripe old age of 19, they still have quality players, and we're going to have to pretty much dominate when the phases of play come in our favour. But I'm very, very pessimistic that these guys will be they'll be superior, so they'll be giving us a tough time, and we'll just have to take the punches and then go for it later in the game. I think that's the best I can ask for. Let me see, can I take the pressure on? No, I'd rather go revenge is a very basic team talk to give. There's very little there's certainly only one narrative you can take from that. There's no second meanings. So anyway, let's bring the crowd noise to the Central Coast Stadium, and let's go for kickoff. Let's see how we get on. Oh dear, that's a terrible kickoff. What are you doing, guys? Connor Payne already collecting the ball, and Saric shoots from distance. Let's just see the name in our stadium. It is the Central Coast Stadium by sheer coincidence. That's great. My A-League knowledge is pretty poor since I gave up playing here in FM12. Here's a set piece from James Milner. Thankfully it's dealt with, and now Peng Changming collects. He goes to the opposite flank with Daniel Moreno, and there's Zheng Long. Doesn't want to shoot first time, but that's assertive play from Shenhua, getting an early corner. Jiming Hao has to retrieve it. Hui Kang to Danny Mullen, and Hui Kang again neutralising the play. Ulsan have scored, so I suspect they'll win. The Japanese teams are underpowered, as the licensing is restricted in this game when you don't patch the game. Not much happening. Push forward again, maybe. Here's Caceres. We're down to fourth position now. It looks like a one-all draw. That's off the crossbar. Oh, so close. James Milner to take this corner, and Hui Kang clears. Connor Payne, good block. And that's dealt with. So we want to shoot on sight, perhaps, and pump the ball into the box. And we'll turn off, get stuck in. We're okay for that now. Connor Payne seemed to have dived. The referee did ignore it, though. Now, a little bit oblivious to the danger. Dovchevsky, through ball. Good block. Daniel Mullen playing in his native Australia for the first time in a few years, I'd say. That's another corner giving us problems. Dovchevsky, Zheng Long able to tackle. And that's cleared for a throw. Oh, nervy stuff here. We haven't had a shot quite often. So here's James Milner, and that's Calustro bringing the halftime period upon us. So let's just check Prozone. It just seems to be one of those performances. So what have we done in the shots department? Well, that's not too bad. We just need to get more crosses into the box, I'm sure. Yeah, that's a big problem. Not many crosses at all. The passing, is actually good. Like, just more key passes, perhaps. Let me see the movement. Okay, four dribbles, that's fair enough. Average positions. And the heat map, what can we see from that? Yeah, pretty routine. To be honest, we might want to get Ziming Hao further forward. And maybe Daniel Moreno as well, so that's something we can do. How about Central Coast? Their crossing isn't much better, to be honest. The passing, again, not much better. Shooting, not much better. Fouling, yeah, they've been fouled 12 times, not something I can do. Saves, yeah, they won't save to make. Oh, they're better dribblers, I will say that much. So, average positions and heat map, yeah, not too much going on there. So let's try and make a few tweaks based on my studies. So Danny Moreno has to go attacking. Ziming Hao has to go attacking as well. Peng Changming looks to be isolated, so we'll make him the defensive forward that he seems to enjoy. Let me see, what else can I do? I think we'll make Mullen a just plain regular defender again, see if that makes a difference. So anyway, that'll do. Team talk time, I'll just say we can still come out with the win, try and give them some confidence, but criticism is still warranted for the midfielders and the lone striker. I'd like to see them do more work, see if we can get the job done. So we'll turn off that, and we'll turn off this, and we'll go roam from positions, see if that makes a difference. Turn off that, and let's go for it, guys. Let's revive our Champions League fortunes and upset the apple cart by beating the A-League Grand Final champions from last year. So there's the group as it stands. We're pretty much in need of wins, unless this result goes in our favour, and that's not going to be easy. So let's demand some more, get them going. Remember what I said in the team talk. Here's Ma Yubin, Kai Hui Kang, Yang Zifei, good back heel. Ming Hao in no man's land, to be honest, but Fu Huan in position. Zifei to Moreno, lovely ball off the crossbar. We are missing Radebe through injury, so that's why he's not playing today. But we just have to take the rough with the smooth, see what we can do. But a positive start to the half here. Zifei backwards to Hui Kang. Ming Hao, Pang Chang Ming, Daniel Moreno. Talk about choking under pressure. Let's go, guys. This is very positive. I'm super chuffed with this, but let's not concede. Oh, Jukchevsky. Very, very narrow margins. Get creative. There's Todd Smith coming on. He must have played badly. Yeah, not no good performance. So let's mark up Todd Smith. He's another youngster, but nevertheless, he serves a grand danger. Now let's bring on a striker of our own, and the man I'm nominating is going to be Zhu Zhen. He will be the advanced forward that I was missing last time. How about I think Zheng Long is struggling, so why not play Fen Yang on the left hand side? We need something different in that department, so let's go for it. There we go, the two substitutes are on, and it is a highlight in the opposition half, but they do cross the whitewash and they're in our half. Ashcroft cutting inside, finds Todd Smith, Caceres, Georgievsky, Connor Payne blocked. So much more positive now from Chentra. We need to finish second to get out of this group. Remember the rules, it's pretty much identical to the UEFA Champions League, but they've brought on another sub. And it looks like a positive change. We're up to third now, but that's bad news, as Ulsan Hyundai have regained the lead. Okay, final change. I think Zifei hasn't played well enough, so bring on Shenglong, put him there, swap around and bring Hui Kang up, see if that works, and bring Ming Hao backwards. Zhu Zhen will be the shadow striker, but I think Li Shenglong will have to take one for the team. and go for a target man role. So we're going to play more direct, we're going to run at the defense, and we're going to go back to standard, I suppose, but we want to control just for a little while longer. So that's my third and final change. If we lose this game, that's my fault. I apologize for bottling it, but yeah, they've made their last sub themselves, so let's mark them up. So if I remember correctly, Morgan is a threat, so mark him up. And Balcom seems to be a third player, so just tighten him. So what can we do here, Shen Shui? A draw is actually a positive result, but take the pressure off. Here we go, Fu Huan. Can they do it? Moreno to Fen Yang. Good save by Lekens. It was straight at him, but it was over his head, so it's never an easy task to keep those shots out. But Shen Shui are starting to ascend into a winning team here. We just need the winning goal. Oh, Moreno completely missed his touch. And that's just unfortunate. But Kai Wee Kang cautioned James Milner down with an injury. And they've made their final changes. So we have to smell blood here. Go for shoot on side, please. It's 88 minutes and 18 seconds. Shang Long tries to win a tackle. He does, after all. Go on, my beauty. It's Jiming Hao. Oh, should have kept it down. I know, shooting on sight was what I ordered. But 4 minutes of stoppage time due to the injury. And it looks like we've missed out on that opportunity. We must beat Ulsan and Saitama to stand any chance of qualification. But it is a challenge that is it is capable of our ability. So 0-0 in the Central Coast Stadium. I'm happy with that. And I think they can be proud. It's a learning experience. But if we're going to be able to take our repeat exam, we're going to have to win the league. So prove the critics wrong. You got the result. Well done. And that will give us confidence. It was, I think both teams didn't live up to the expectations. But I just wish they didn't have your man Rick Scott available to them in the first game. That made a big difference. So basically, we need to beat Saitama. That'll put us on 7 points. We need Central Coast to win that game so we get the 1 point lead. And then we need to draw or beat Ulsan. That is the most logical method of achieving success. So good news for Chinese clubs. Meizu got a draw. Shangang actually went to Australia and won, so that deserves a lot of respect. So let's just quickly conclude the group stages after four games. So Shangang are within a shout again. That's a great result. Meizu are pretty much gone. They need a miracle. But Shenhua, they need to win once more against Saitama and then rely on other results and then get Ulsan. So the next game is indeed against Ulsan, which means if we lose, we're gone. And if we win again, that'll be a huge result and it'll give us some sort of belief. So we'll see you for that game and hope. I hope we don't throw the league away. It's so important to defend the title, and I'm sure you'll agree with me on that one. So I'll see you again in the next episode. Bye now.